Halo, kita lanjutkan persiapan Matematika ASEAN Scholarship. Kali ini kita akan membahas contoh soal Primary 6 Singapore untuk persiapan entry level secondary 1. Soal yang akan dibahas adalah soal Primary 6 dari Nanyang Primary School yang diambil dari website www.testpapers.com. Dalam video kali ini, ada soal-soal yang berupa tipe pilihan berganda dan juga ada bagian soal yang boleh dikerjakan menggunakan kalkulator. Namun, kalau kita melihat ke website resmi MUI, di sana disebutkan sesuai format dan aturannya bahwa tidak ada jenis soal pilihan berganda. Jadi, cuma ada jenis soal short answer questions dan open-ended questions. Juga disebutkan bahwa penggunaan kalkulator tidak dibolehkan. Kemudian di sini juga disebutkan bahwa waktu pengerjaannya adalah selama 2 jam. Jadi contoh soal yang diberikan ini hanya untuk menunjukkan tingkat kesulitan dari soal-soal primary 6 saja.
Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we'll be taking a look at 5 questions from Singapore's primary 6 math examinations. Let's get started right away. So the first question we're going to take a look at is question 5, a multiple choice question, which is about geometry. So this will be about finding the angle DAC right here. Before we're going to do this question, we're first just going to quickly revise that sum of the angles in a triangle is equals to 180 degrees, while the sum of the angles in a quadrilateral, a shape with four sides, is equals to 360 degrees. So these two information will help us solve this question. And the first step of this question is finding the angle BDE. Angle BDE is actually equals to, I'm going to erase this right here, is equals to 180 degrees minus 90 degrees. So 180 degrees is the sum of the angles in the triangle, and 90 degrees is this right angle right here, and minus 32 degrees, which is angle EBD. And this will get us 58 degrees. So now we immediately found out that this is 58 degrees. And the next step is actually immediately finding the final answer, which is the angle DAC right here. And now we're going to use this information right here, 360 degrees. So the angle DAC is equals to 360 degrees minus 90 degrees, which is this right angle, minus 118 degrees, which is this angle right here, and finally minus the angle we just found, minus 58 degrees. And this should get you 94 degrees. So the answer is option 2, 94 degrees. For the next question, we're going to take a look at another multiple choice question, but this time we're going to take a look at ratios. So question 14 right here, Viv, Wendy, and Sunil each had some beads, and they each used the same number of beads to make a necklace. So this is a very important part of the question. They each used the same number of beads, and each of them used a different ratio, a different fraction of the number of beads they originally had to make that necklace. And the question is asking, what was the original ratio of the number of beads Viv had to the first number of beads Wendy had, and so on. And this question is called repeated identity question, and it's one of the common questions that come out in Singapore primary school examinations. So let's try to solve this question step by step. So firstly, I'm going to write down the ratios, and this will be the ratios between the number of necklaces used and the total each of them first had. So this is Viv's ratio, which is 1 to 3. And Wendy's ratio would be 7 to 8. While Sin E's ratio would be 3 to 4. So again, this each of these is used, the number of beads used to the number of total beads. And notice that in the question, they said that the number of beads used is equal. So the next step we're going to do right here is we're going to try to equalize each of these numbers. And we're going to change the ratios accordingly. So notice that for the numbers 1, 7, and 3, the common multiple that each of them has is the number 21. So we're going to change this ratio, each of them, such that the used bits will be 21. So changing the ratios accordingly, we will get 21 to 63 for Viv, 21 to 24 for Wendy, and 21 to 28 for Cindy. And just a quick recap for those of you who are unsure how this happened. To change the ratios from one form to another, from here we can see that we multiply by 21. So in the right side, we should also multiply by 21. So 3 multiplied by 21 becomes 63. And here, 7 to 21 is a multiplication of 3. So that's exactly what happened here as well. And the final answer would actually be option 4, because notice that for Viv, the total number of beads is 63 units, for Wendy it's 24 units, and Sin-E is 28 units. And that's exactly what this is. Now for the next question, we're going to move on to short answer questions. Question 21, which is about lowest common multiple. So this question is talking about a faulty traffic light, which has its red light blinking every 2 seconds, its amber light blinking every 3 seconds, and its green light blinking every 8 seconds. So let's just highlight these three numbers first, 2, 3, and 8 seconds. And if all three lights blink now, how many seconds will they all blink together again? And the first step of this question is, of course, identifying that this is actually talking about the lowest common multiple, or the LCM. And you can visualize this in different way, but you can sort of do it like this, where the red light blinks every 2 seconds. So this is second 0, 1, 2, 4, 6, and so on, while the amber light blinks every 3 seconds, so 3, 6, and so on, and the green light blinks every 8 seconds. So you'll notice that we need to find the first number where each of them blinks together. So that's essentially what lowest common multiple is. And just to recap on how to find the lowest common multiple, first we just write down all the multiples of each number. So 2 is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24. And for 3 is 3, 6, 9, 12. 15, 18, 21, 24, and for 8 is 8, 16, and 24. Now the goal here is we want to find a number, the first number that appears in all three of these lists at once. So looking at the number 2, we see that 12 actually appears in both 2 and 3, 6 as well, but it doesn't appear for the number 8. So that's not the lowest common multiple for the three of them. And if you look slowly, you'll notice that the first number is actually 24, first number that appears in all three of these numbers. So now we know that the LCM is 24, and that's actually the final answer right here. How many seconds later will they all blink together again? It's 24 seconds. Or you can write it as 24s. Now let's move on to question 26, which is on fractions. So in question 26, Mrs. Shen sold 1/3 of her apples on Monday. She sold 1/3 of her apples on Monday, and she sold 2/3 of the remaining apples on Tuesday. And Mrs. Shen had 14 apples left after selling the apples on Monday and Tuesday. How many apples did Mrs. Shen have at first? So in this type of question, we must first know that at first, she has one whole of the number of apples she had. So we don't know how many apples she had at first. She first had, in a sense, you can call it one unit, but she said one whole. She had one whole of what she had at first. And after she sold 1/3 of her apples on Monday, then she would have 2/3 left. So after she sold 1/3, she would have 2/3 left. And after that, she sold 2/3 of the remaining apples on Tuesday. And the remaining apples is actually referring to these 2/3 that is left. So this 2/3 here is the remaining apples. And how do we calculate the number of apples that is left after she sold 2/3 of the remaining? So notice that if you sell 2/3 of the remaining, you will be left with 1/3 of the remaining. Because one is one whole of the remaining. minus two-thirds would be one-third of the remaining. And to get the actual fraction, you would need to multiply it by the two-thirds. So multiply it by one-third, which is the fraction of the remaining that is left. And you'll get that you'll have two-ninths of apples, of the remaining apples. Sorry, two-ninths of the original apples that she had at first. So, and this is actually equals to 14. So, two-ninths of the original apple is 14 apples. Now we're going to find out how many apples did Mrs. Chen have at first. And at first, she had one whole. So, how do we get from here to here? And we notice that this is actually a multiplication of 9 over 2. If you, a quick recap on why this is the case, is because when you multiply by the reciprocal of the fraction, which is flipped upside down, you would get 1. So it doesn't matter what fraction it is, 1 is equals to 2 thirds times 3 over 2, 1 is equals to, let's say, 27 over 81 times 81 over 27. When you multiply by the fraction flipped upside down, you will always get 1, because these two will cancel out. Okay, so anyways, we notice that this is a multiplication of 9 over 2, so we should do the same for the right side, which is a multiplication of 9 over 2. And this would be equals to the same as 14 over 1 times 9 over 2. You're canceling this out, you would get 63 apples. So the answer is 63 apples. Now for the last question, we're going to move on to paper 2, the last question of paper 2. And a recap from last week is that paper 2 is the paper where we're allowed to use a calculator. So unlike paper 1, where we're not allowed to use calculator, we can just plug in our calculations into the calculator for the questions in paper 2. Okay, so last question is actually a geometry question, finding the shaded area, which is these three right here. And this question looks intimidating for many students, but in these types of complicated questions, what we need to do is we just need to dissect the information one by one. So immediately just read the question, we'll see that the figure is made up of a semicircle, this semicircle right here, two identical quarter circles, which are these two, and two identical right isosceles triangle, ACB and ACD, which are these two. So CA is equals to CB is equals to CD. So this right here is equals to this and this. So they're all 28 centimeters. And that's a good thing, because immediately we can see that AC right here is a diameter of the circle, because O is the center and it passes through the center. So immediately we can find out that the diameter is actually 28 centimeters. And that also means that the radius is 14 centimeters, which is half of 28 centimeters. And we want to find the shaded area of the figure, the total shaded area. And how we are supposed to do that is, firstly, notice that taking this area right here is actually very useful for us, because after that, we can just subtract it from this part to get the total of these two shaded areas. So that's exactly what I'm going to do right here. I'm going to find the area of the triangle ADB, which is actually just half times 56 centimeters, because the base is 56 centimeters, or 2 times 28 centimeters. Because this is also 28, multiplied by the height, which is AC right here, and we already know that that's 28 centimeters. So this should get us 784 centimeters squared if you plug into your calculator. And next is we want to basically subtract this value by this area right here. Okay, so that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to get the I'm going to do 784 centimeters squared minus off by firstly the area of the semicircle, sorry, this semicircle right here, this semicircle, and that would be half times 3.14, which is pi according to the question, multiplied by the radius squared. So that's the formula of the semicircle. And I also need to subtract it by this triangle right here, an unnamed triangle, which I just highlighted. And that would just be equals to half times the base, which is 28 centimeters, because this is also the diameter of the circle, multiplied by the height, which is 14 centimeters, because that's the radius of the circle. So this is 14. And if you calculate this, this would actually give you a decimal number, which is 280.28 centimeters. 280.28 centimeters squared. And now we're only one step away from the final answer, which is adding on this answer by this shaded area right here. But how exactly do we find this shaded area? It might look a bit complicated, but it's actually really not. Because this part right here is a triangle that we can find. And this whole part is a quarter circle. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to get the area of the quarter circle. Sorry, I accidentally deleted the calculations, but the final calculation should have been 280.28 centimeters squared. And this 280.28 meters squared is basically these two shaded areas right here. Okay, anyways, now I'm going to find the area of the quarter circle, which is a quarter multiplied by 3.14 multiplied by 14 squared. And I also need to subtract that by the area of the triangle, which is the area of the triangle right here, this triangle. And that would just be equals to half times 14 times 14, which is 55.86. So this is 55.86 centimeters squared. And now you need to add it up to this part right here, which will get you the final answer of 280. Plus 55.86 centimeters squared equals to 336.40 centimeters squared.